Hello friends, myself Dr. Harmeet Goyal. Today I brought a important information to share with you. Like many of my students studying in India and abroad, they have been asking me, ma'am, what are the career options after MBBS? So I tried to compile the information and I'm sharing you in this video some of the important slides. First of all, the important career option for you is the post-graduation in India. That means doing MD or MS or DNB. For that, you have to write the NEET PG exam, AIIMS PG, PGI Chandigarh or JIPMER PG. This year 2020, all the four exams have been taken and the students have joined their respective field depending upon their rank in the various PG entrance exams. Now maybe next time it's going to be NEXT exam. For that we will share the information in the subsequent videos. Next is you have an option to do post-graduation from abroad. In this regard, there is US Emily, that is from USA, PLAC, that is UK, AMC, that is Australia, or PG in Germany, which is also an upcoming option nowadays, then from China, etc. So these are the places where you can do your post-graduation from. Now the third option for you is the UPSC exam, Union Public Service Commission. That is, you have to check when you're checking the website, Combined Medical Services exam. This year, they are just about to release the form and it is online and you can fill the form and you can write the exam. This is a permanent job and the jobs are in the railways, the CGHS, the GDMO, that is General Duty Medical Officer in the MCD, Municipal Corporation of Delhi, or Indian Ordnance Factory. About the UPSC exam, the details, what is the prospectus, what are the 10-year paper, which book you have to follow, what are the subjects, like there is paper 1, paper 2, and the exam is 500 marks and there is 100 marks personality test, okay? That you can follow my YouTube video with the name of UPSC CMS exam. So UPSC is being conducted and this UPSC building is in Dholpur House, that is in Delhi. Now fourth option is you can become a teaching faculty like us. Like after finishing the PG, many of me, like people like me and my colleagues, they've taken up the teaching option. For me, it just came by chance, but by continuous teaching for many years and all, I have gained the popularity. I've written the books. Many of the students are the followers and the income is also good. So you can think of a teaching option, but it's better that you join after finishing your post-graduation so that a specific subject you can teach. Okay, so there are various reputed medical coaching institute, face-to-face teaching you can do, online teaching you can do, you can make test series and earn money. There's a handsome payment. Only thing is your command in the subject should be very good and your way of delivering the subject should be from good to excellent and you should have knowledge of the latest updates. Another option is MBA in hospital management. So there are many universities which are offering these courses, like postgraduate diploma in hospital management from National Institute of Health and Family Welfare, Munirka, Delhi. It's a one-year diploma, but you need to have 5 years experience after your MBBS. So it's a correspondence course. And after finishing my PG, I have done this course from National Institute of Health and Family Welfare, and I've got the certificate. There's a degree course also available. You can do the degree course regular from the Delhi University. There are around 18 to 20 seats. You can check up in the website. There is a correspondence course also that you can do it from Simsys Pune or from IGNU. Okay. And after doing this course, you can apply for the job of the superintendent or additional medical superintendent in various private or corporate hospitals. Then you can do PG degree, postgraduate degree in hospital administration. That is master's degree in hospital administration. This degree course is being offered from the AIIMS, PGI Chandigarh, Tata Institute, etc. So you have to well check their websites and the prospectus if you are interested in doing masters in hospital administration. After doing this course, you get eligible to become the medical superintendent, or in the administrative services, you can go into the various reputed medical colleges of India and abroad. Then short service commission, like defense services, there is no written exam. There is only an interview, personality test, and age is less than 45 years, and you can get the benefit in the PG seat later. So short service commission, I think they have contract for 5 years. You have to check the updates from their websites or from the employment news. Another career option is, if you want to earn money fast after doing your MBBS, your internship is complete and valid, then you can apply for the junior resident post, that is house job in the government hospital. For that, you have to check the vacancy, and there is always an interview for the appointments. Okay, so they take a regular 6 months, and then 6 months it has to be renewed. Fine. And there's a good salary if you do it from Delhi or good metropolitan hospital, and you get a certificate. Good house jobs you should be doing either in medicine or in obs gyn or pediatrics or in the casual if you want to do your independence. So simultaneously doing this house job, you can prepare for your PG and you can become independent in life. Another option is RMO, that is resident medical officer post, that is in the private hospital. You can do shift duties like 9 to 2, or you can do 2-to-8 duty or the night. You can earn money. You can simultaneously prepare for your UPSC or the PG seat. And you can become independent, you can earn money, do duties, whatever time you want. There are plenty of hospitals in Delhi and outside Delhi also. Another option is, you can do a fellowship or the certificate course in emergency medicine, which is very, very upcoming and demanding branch. So this course is being offered by Apollo Hospital, Max Hospital, and other hospitals. You can check up their websites and all that. You can apply, you can go to the administration and just ask about this course and fill up. And you become capable to do work in the casualty, in the private hospitals, and they offer the good salary. Maybe the starting salary can be 1 lakh per month. Another is, you can do a training or the fellowship in the critical care medicine. Then there is, you can apply for the IAS, that is civil services exam. Mind it, this UPSC, this is different from UPSC Combined Medical Services exam. This is for IAS, IRS, Indian Forest Service, the Indian Police Services exam and all that. So after MBBS, you are eligible, and the subject selection is your own choice. Then you can do Masters in Public Health. And this course has been offered by AIIMS, PGI, Guru Gobind Singh, Indraprastha University, etc. Another one is clinical research. If you're very much interested in clinical research, okay, then you can do MSc in clinical research, or you can do PG, PhD from the AIIMS, PGI or JIPMER, reputed colleges and institutions from India. This ICMR building, I'm just showing, there's an ICMR building, okay. So you can apply for this clinical research post, and this course is available. Yes, also. Then you can do MTech. There's an upcoming branch of biomedical engineering. Okay, so when you have to explore, friends, in detail about this, depending upon your interest. Or if you want to earn your own money, you have your setup, you have your OPD sitting or chamber, then you can do your own practice. Only thing is your availability, your politeness and your quick clinical experience that will help you in this field. Then there is another option like medical journalism, where you can the medic writers. So medical journalism is another field for medical. There is like medical transcription, which I just add here, medical transcription. Like there is a general transcription. Similarly, you can earn by medical, by serving as a medical transcriptor. Then there is a diploma or this, like after post MBBS, the certificate course in the critical care, or there is fellowship in dialysis, there is fellowship in the diabetes mellitus management, there's a certificate course, and you can just restrict your field to the diabetes management. Then fellowship in neurological rehabilitation, fellowship in ultrasound, there are many, many branches. So just few I've written for you. Another field is you can work in WHO or UNICEF. You should have an MBBS degree, and you can work as a surveillance medical officer. You can check up the WHO or UNICEF websites for that. Then you can join an NGO that is also in a very much upcoming branch. After finishing my PG, I just looked forward for some of the NGOs, and they were offering me that you do the this family planning services, and we have the camps and all that. So for just few months, I just joined. Later on, I got the job of the senior residency. So I joined the MCD hospital for doing my senior residency. So you can join NGO and you can do good work in the public health. Then there is a postgraduate diploma in the nutrition and dietetics department. So you can just join, and there are job options in various private nutrition companies and all. Then there is floating doctor, like you can serve and join as a medical to the crews and all. Well, that you have to search for that. Then there is a palliative care physician, that is another branch. Then there is hair and skin expert, postgraduate diploma in medical cosmetology, or postgraduate diploma in clinical cosmetology that you can do. Then obesity and weight management, that is also a very much upcoming branch. Obesity and waste management, this is the priority nowadays. Then there are other options like sexologist, there is clinical embryologist in IVF techniques, assisted reproductive techniques, courses are there. But it's better that after finishing your PG, if you do these courses in IVF, so IVF is very, very upcoming and paying branch. There's a course in the genetics and all that, so you can look forward for that. Well, these are some of the options which I searched for you. There are many more. So follow me on my Facebook account, the Instagram, and my YouTube channel. Thank you very much.